Thank you very much. I'm from the Laboratory of Vaccines of the Developing World at the Institute for Glycomics at Griffith University. The laboratory was only opened formally 2 weeks ago. The vision of the laboratory is listed here to improve the health of people in poor and developing countries through the development and deployment of new vaccines, so making them and making sure they're cheap enough to be used. The laboratory looks at two vaccines in particular, malaria and rheumatic heart disease, but this afternoon I want to focus on malaria and share with you some discoveries that we've made only recently in the last 6 or so months, coming at the end of, though, about 25 years of research that I've done on the topic. So what's the need for a malaria vaccine? Let's consider what malaria does to the world's population, mainly children. It infects people in 109 countries. About 1 million children, young children, die every year from malaria, mostly under the age of 5, and 90% of those deaths occur in African children. Currently, there's no vaccine or drug control programs that are effective and sustainable in poorer countries. Australians don't catch malaria within Australia, but about 1,000 Australians do acquire it through travel to neighbouring regions. You need a mosquito, which is infected from another person, to transmit malaria. And here you can see on the slide the malaria parasites, two different species infecting human red blood cells. The one on the left is Plasmodium falciparum, and the one on the right is Plasmodium vivax. So I want to tell you about a strategy, a very new strategy, to develop a vaccine that we believe will be able to protect against all the strains and indeed all the different species of malaria parasites that infect humans. We call it PlasProtect. Plas is the shorthand for Plasmodium, which is the genus name of the malaria parasite, Plasmodium. And Protect is obvious, protects against malaria. And the capital T means that it's working through a form of immune cell or white blood cell called a T cell, which is a very novel strategy for making a malaria vaccine. There are two key aspects of the discovery. One is that we found that very low doses of malaria parasites can stimulate a protective immune response involving those T cells. On the other hand, high parasite doses, as would occur in a natural malaria infection, do not stimulate those protective T cells. By contrast, they actually destroy those protective T cells. So using very low doses of a malaria parasite are critical. The question was, how could you expose a person to low doses of malaria parasite safely? And very recently, we've come across this new drug called centamycin, which can attenuate the parasite. That means, I describe it as putting it to sleep, enabling low numbers of sleeping parasites to then be safely administered to as a vaccine and induce immunity. Here's a picture of the drug here, centamycin. It binds in the DNA, and I think the next slide might show that. Binds adenines within the DNA and stops the parasite from replicating, but it doesn't actually kill it outright. So the parasite's still there inside the red blood cells, and that's what we use as a vaccine. We've modelled this in laboratory animals, mice. So how do we make this PlasProtect malaria vaccine? We harvest the malaria parasites from an animal. When we come to make a human vaccine, we'll take the parasite that we culture in the test tube. We incubate it in vitro with the drug for half an hour. We wash the parasites to remove the free drug, and then we then count the number of parasites and inject a small number of parasites into the animal, a very small number. It's a very, very simple technology. The concept behind it is anything but simple, but to make the vaccine is very simple technology. So this is just a couple of slides of data, and I'll finish. There are two data slides here, or two pieces of information, showing how this vaccine can protect against, on the left, a parasite called Plasmodium ewellii, and on the right, a parasite called Plasmodium shibaudi. The filled circles are what happens to the parasites in the blood of mice who have not been vaccinated. And you can see on the left, the parasite grows to a certain degree in the blood, and then the mouse is able to cure that parasite. On the right, the parasite grows and the mouse is unable to cure that parasite, and those mice have to be euthanized, otherwise they would die of the malaria infection. However, the malaria vaccine, PlasProtect, protects those mice completely, which you can see through the open circles on the left and right. So a single injection of this vaccine is highly protective. And one other slide shows a similar sort of thing, where mice on the left were protected, they're the open circles, and the filled squares are the mice who were not protected, who were not vaccinated. And then we come back 3 months later and give those mice a second infection of a different strain of malaria. One's called Plasmodium shibaudi AS and one's called Plasmodium shibaudi AJ, and those mice are also protected completely, whereas the control mice are not. So just finishing off now. So what is our dream? Very simply, the dream is a world without malaria. And we're in the process now of testing this concept which we've developed at the Institute for Glycomics here on the Gold Coast in what's called a phase 1 or first in human clinical trial. Thank you.